full house here, huh? So my name is Danny Young. I'm with Prenetics. What we're doing is personalized medicine. So technology has disrupted much of our lives, except for one industry, healthcare. And that's why I want to disrupt. I want to disrupt how we, So what's the main problem? So when we go see a doctor, typically we get one medication prescribed for one everybody. So basically, we have a panel of six people here. We'll probably get the same dosage, same medication for everyone. What we want to do is change that into getting personalized medicine. And why is that a problem? Every year, there's 2.2 million people suffer from adverse drug effects in the U.S. And the FDA has publicly said there's $136 billion could be saved in healthcare costs with the use of pharmacogenomic testing. Every year, there's also 100,000 people are 100,000 deaths are caused by the wrong drugs. Imagine that for a second. Every day, that means there's a plane crash for 300 people, 365 days a year. That's a big problem, and that's what we want to solve. The answer is pharmacogenomic testing. It's a one-time, one test. And what is pharmacogenomic testing? Here's a short video by the Mayo Clinic, which is the world's largest nonprofit organization.
One medication can save a life, but a medication that works well for other people might not work for you, and may result in significant side effects. Pharmacogenomics is the study of how our genes affect the way our bodies respond to medications. Because of their genetic makeup, some people's bodies break down certain medications too slowly. The medication builds up in the body, causing severe side effects. Other people's bodies break down the same medication too quickly, eliminating it before it has a chance to work at effective levels. Yet others may be predisposed to have significant, sometimes life-threatening side effects from a medication simply from having the wrong genes. Scientists at Mayo Clinic are investigating how specific variations in genes affect how well certain medications work in the body. Using this information, doctors can examine your genetic profile to predict whether a medication is likely to help you or hurt you before you even take it.
So what we have developed is a technology to analyze 9 genes, over 1.4 million gene-drug interactions, and come up with a simple report. What we're doing is chronic illnesses. Basically, if you have cardiovascular, pain management, psychiatric, ADHD, and hypersensitivity, you'll be able to do our test and understand how drugs will affect you even before you take it. Our report is very simple to use. On the green section, you can hear these are drugs are okay for you. Yellow is increase the dosage, orange decrease dosage. Red's very important, and this is information physicians never had access to, is to avoid these drugs which could potentially hurt you. Why is this currently technology available now? Because DNA sequence cost has dropped even below Moore's law. In 2001, the cost used to cost 100 million USD just to sequence one genome. Today, it costs 1,000 USD. In 2004, our technology used to cost $300,000 per test. Clinically, it didn't make sense because it's too expensive. Today, we're going to launch this product for 300 USD to physicians. In the US, FDA, Mayo Clinic, Medicare, United Healthcare, which is the major insurance company, have already supported this. We want to roll this out in Asia. In terms of my team, I'm not a PhD, but I have a team of excellent world-class scientists. I only have a GED. I'm a serial entrepreneur, started my first business at 25. Last company was acquired by Groupon. I was the CEO for East Asia from 2010 to 2014. I moved to healthcare because I want to make a social impact, and at the same time, this is a really big opportunity. We're forecasting by 2018 is $1 billion USD valuation. These are conservative estimates, but I'd rather over-deliver than over a promise. I want to create Hong Kong's first ever unicorn based upon right drug, right dosage, right from the beginning. We have distribution partners set up all across Southeast Asia already, and we also have insurance company, which is coming on strategically as well.
Great, thank you. Judges?
I had a question really about regulatory considerations. Mm-hmm. You mentioned the U.S., but then you mentioned Hong Kong.
Yes.
You know, what are the regulatory considerations for one of these
So for what we are doing, there is no regular issues because there's no ethical issues here. Because what we're providing is we're providing for the physicians a report they can use to better give patients their medication properly. In the U.S., there's no need for FDA approval as well for this product. So in China, there are regulations, but our market is, you know, Southeast Asia, Hong Kong, Taiwan, Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand as well.
This is a
highly risky proposition, although it is promising. In terms of developing drugs, it takes years and years and years before a drug can be approved, right? Because this is not a device you wear.
Correct.
This is something you take.
Mm-hmm.
It could actually kill you
yes.
if it's not the right thing,
Correct.
Right? So do you think you have the depth of management to really take this enterprise from nothing to a successful business?
Yes, definitely wise, right? I mean, I've been a serial entrepreneur my whole life, so that adds to the element. So I have a team of PhDs. So that's actually, I did not find this company. I actually invested in this company. I came on board as the CEO because I was like, wow, this is awesome technology you guys are creating, and I want to take this to the next level. And that's why even before we launched, we have established these partnerships with clinics, hospitals, and insurance companies. They're coming on board not as partners. They're like, wow, they want to invest in us.
What about the large pharma companies? How do you get the buy-in from them?
There will be a conflict of interest because potentially the pharma companies will make less money. So one thing pharma companies do not tell you when they do their drug trials, they're looking for extensive metabolizers, people that metabolize normally, and that's only 50% of the population. We could actually be poor metabolizers, intermediate metabolizers, high rapid metabolizers. So they don't tell you that. So what we're doing is figuring out that test and basically make sure that you get the right drug.
Who pays for the testing? Is it the consumer?
Insurance companies, right? So there's two parts to this. Insurance needs to pay for this, policyholders, and government. And then the other side, we need a physician's buy-ins, and that's why we have the clinics and hospitals involved. But even out-of-pocket costs is only, in the U.S. it costs $800 to $2,100 per test. We understand the cultural difference in Asia, so we're actually lowering that cost to $300 USD. So we want to keep it mass market, lower margins, but I think this is something that consumers, physicians, and patients will be well rewarded with.
Great. Thank you very much, Danny and Prenetics. Give a round of applause.
Thank you.